What we're going to do is sharpen a knife on a stone. And what is the right angle to hold your blade? What's the right stone? At what point would you do a Damascus knife? A lot of those questions are out there. And the stone is really, my favorite is this Norton. I have some very, very nice Arkansas stones. But depending on what kind of edge I want, I may use one of those, depending on what kind of knife I'm building for what purpose. And you'll see a lot of these sharpening stones, they come with this little angle thing and they say, well, that's the correct angle. Well, is it? This knife is tapered two directions. It's tapered from here to here, and it's tapered from spine to edge. So if I use that angle, as soon as I move that knife down that cutting edge, now it's a different angle, because this got thinner and this got steeper. So that's really not something that you could use unless your knife is perfectly flat, perfectly straight, with parallel sides. So, to me, the best angle is when you come off the geometry of your grind. You're getting the correct geometry in here off your grinder. So when I go to the stone, all I want to do is lay it down steep enough, but not so steep that it mars the side up. So all I want to do is the cutting edge. So somewhere along into that area. Now as I drag this forward, that angle changes, so I have to change it with my hand. So as I drag it forward, I like to put one hand here to rest so that I can feel that angle with this hand. So I'm actually rotating this blade and lifting it up as I get closer to the point. When I get out here to the point, I may be at this angle. So you can see right away, it's quite a bit different, you know.
Now, would this be the same way you would do all the knives that you have, hunters, bullies, whatever?
Yeah.
Okay. At that steep of a, assuming you're
depending on
the
thickness of the blade.
Okay.
Depending on, you know.
Because I was just looking at that.
Because they're all going to change.
That's way shallower than anything I normally do.
Yeah. I like to use WD-40 simply because it'll float all those grindings out of that stone. You don't want that stone to load up with all those grindings off of there. So when am I ready to go to the stone is when I come off of my grinder and I see that little burr form on the edge. You can actually feel that burr with your finger. A lot of questions are out there. Okay, do you go forward? Do you go backwards? Do you do circular motions? Sure. Any of those will work.
Yes.
Sure. Personally, I like to cut into the stone. If I go away from the cutting edge, it actually creates a longer burr. And it'll cut really well, but for a shorter length of time. Mm-hmm. That burr will roll over faster. But if I cut into the stone like this, it still creates that burr, but it lasts much longer.
Durable.
And I always feel of that as I make that pass. I feel of that and feel that burr should be more predominantly on this side and nothing over here. So what you want to do is whatever stroke you make on this side, do the same number on the other. Now one thing too, when you come off of your grinder, you're using a 2-inch wide belt. There's going to be high and low spots. And when you make a pass or two on this stone, you can actually look down your cutting edge. I don't know how many of you guys can see this.
Yeah, but you can see
those high spots are.
You can see the difference, yeah.
You can't send that knife to your customer that way. He can't sharpen it.
Right.
So before you go through the trouble of hand sanding your knife, sharpen it on the stone. Then hand sand it. Then go back and resharpen it. Because you want to hone all those high spots off and then hand sand your knife. And when you hand sand it, you're going to take your cutting edge off and then go back and all you'll have to do is maybe one or two passes. Now you can look down through here, guys, and you can see where the stone is cut all but one spot.
Sure, yeah, it's the one spot.
And so you've got to keep honing until
it's straight.
Till it's straight, sure. Everywhere.
And you do that before your hand sand?
Before your hand sand.
Interesting.
Because if you wait until after your hand sand, you still got them
high spots.
You're going to hand sand them valleys and ridges. So get that off first, then hand sand it. And then come back and you just got a light touch and you're done. You know, the knife's pretty sharp right now, but we don't have all that badly out there.
Sure.
Is that an India stone there, or what'd you got?
You know, a good way of testing your cutting edge is put it on your thumb. If it sticks like that, you know, it's sharp. And anywhere it doesn't stick, then you need to go back and
it'll slide off.
Yeah, it'll just slide down.
I mean, does that mean
like
it's not at a zero if it
it's
just slides off?
It's not a zero.
Off.
It doesn't have that hair burr on the edge.
I've seen people.
Or the burr's turned the other direction.
Right, flipped over, didn't come off.
Right.
I've seen people flat grind to zero, but I'd be afraid to use the knife for anything.
I like to use leather with rouge on it. After I've done the stone, and I pull it away, you don't want to cut into that, or you'll just cut your leather.
Now, I've seen the leather straps on one side, they've got a rougher leather, and on the back side, they've got a smoother. Is it just a matter of what kind of polish you're looking for?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's that green you had on there, Cookie?
The what?
Was that green?
Red, I think.
Red, okay.
Red rouge.
Wow. Now,
is that better than an oil soaked strop or a leather belt?
Yeah, that rouge actually helps that cutting edge. Questions earlier about if it has a clip, does it have to be sharpened? Why would you put a clip on it if you didn't want to sharpen it? Only for weight reduction.
Sure.
And there's nothing wrong with, but if it is just for weight reduction, don't bring it down to a zero like this. I'm assuming this knife was made to be sharpened because the edge goes to zero. So how do you sharpen it? Same way.
Will it take a steeper cutting edge?
At a steeper angle. Yes, it will.
Oh, really?
But it won't cut through because the bevel's not as long.
Right.
It's too thin.
Too thick.
Like higher cutting edge. Like
but will it shave? Yes, it'll shave just as well as this primary edge.
Didn't realize that.
But it's a much steeper angle. And you're going to find the same thing on this edge. It's a little harder to do this because this side's razor sharp now that you're trying to
be careful now.
So, you know, don't let your hand slip.
Do you use leather strap on all of your stuff like that?
So your clip has a concave appearance to it. How do you sharpen it?
I'm sorry?
Your clip, can it have a concave appearance to it?
Concave?
You mean hologram?
Hologram?
Yeah,
clip?
How do you do that?
How do you sharpen it?
The same way you sharpen a hologram knife. Just all you're doing is that very edge in. Keep in mind that hollow ground is going to be very, very weak.
Excuse me. Yeah.
You wouldn't want to do any type of heavy chopping with it because that edge will wrinkle if it's heat treated properly. This India stone, it's going to want to cut meat before it'll shave. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it will shave. This stone here, it's going to just want to shave. You can make it cut meat, but not as aggressively as.
I always think of it in terms of the really, really small saw blades.
Yes, little micro teeth.
Itty bitty.
So, if I was making a caping knife, I would come back on this stone and just fine hone it.
And you can just hear the difference in that.
Oh, yeah, it's really different. It sounds like. You know, I've seen people sharpen knives all different ways, you know, like cutting away or circular, and they all work.
Right.
The most important thing is keeping that angle, whatever it is.
Yeah.
whatever the angle is from this side, that's why I hold my hand here, and I can kind of judge the height of the spine. Mm. When you turn over, you want that same angle. Whatever this side was, you want that one.